What's going on, everybody? It's Ollie Angry Nerd again today, and we're playing some more El Spooky Cavalcade, I can't remember the name of it. It's been a while. But we're doing my horror show right now. Let's hope this game loads up. Okay, good. It did load up. So, now, one game that I did have that I actually wanted to do was Overwatch. Because Overwatch had some new DLCs and new whatever. But it didn't let me on there because the connection's been kind of iffy all day. So, this was a game that I wanted to do a Let's Play of. But the thing with me was, I don't got anybody to fucking play this game with. And that's the problem. Like, I love fucking the Sniper Elite Trilogy. I love it. I love 1, 2, and 3. 2 was fucking sick. 3 was awesome. I heard 1 was alright. And then when I found out they're making a zombie World War II game, I was like, you know, I always thought that Call of Duty World War, or like the World War Zombies, was fucking sick. And it was like, we're adding a story? That's even better. But this game is hard as shit. I'ma tell you that for free. It is hard. Also too, for me, I like playing the harder difficulties. But just to have a talk about this game. A lot of people didn't like it because Sniper Elite 3 was already out by then. And a lot of people felt like this was more or less a downgrade of that game. But to me, I don't find it to be a downgrade. Honestly, I like this game better, I guess. Like, Sniper Elite 3 was good, like, just as, like, a, you know, a decent military shooter. But I love Zombie Army Trilogy, and I love that they added the three games that were Zombie Army. And, can I just, like, make my own match? Like, that's something I want to see if I can do. Yeah, let me create a private lobby, and then I'll just start it from the beginning. And also, to break the immersion. Okay, good, I'm in a party. Alright. But, let me see. It's not change gameplay mode. Oh yeah, sure, change gameplay mode. I haven't really, like, set difficulty. Friendly fire, chat, invite friend, like, can I, like, unlock the session? Like, that's something I want to do. Sorry, I just kind of jumped this game because I was like, man, I want to do it. Like, I really hope this game just wasn't, like, quick match. If it was quick match, that's fine. I guess that just means play single player. But, any campaign horde. I guess I am gonna be rocking solo. Alright. Well, that sucks.
Carl Fairburn. OSS.
Okay,
Dr.
Yeah, here.
Ephraim Schweiger.
This is what I like Fairburn, too, with this game.
OSS operative. Focused and fearless.
I'll let him quit
unmatched
talking.
Unmatched with a sniper rifle. Spent most of the war operating alone behind enemy lines. Not used to working in a team, but willing to adapt if circumstances require it. For example, if confronted by millions of bloodthirsty Nazi zombies.
But, all right. This is what I like about this game. I like that they're, like, you know, you have the top four males and you have the bottom females. That's what I like, because it gives more of a, like, a selection to characters. And I always thought that was really cool about this game, that I kind of wish more zombie games did. And to talk about a game that's kind of like a zombie game, that, like, plays a lot like Left 4 Dead 2. Sorry, here, let me move this. It's not Verdun. No, that's the World War One game. Vermintide. Vermintide's like that, where you have five characters to pick from, and it's awesome because, you know, you're not gonna be a person that you don't want. Like, they'll be like, hey, do you want to play as this guy? They'll give you that guy.
Hermann Wolf.
And also, do I want to be the Captain. Nazi guy? I always just thought the Nazi dude looked cool. Difficulty character, and then we'll just start it, why not?
Germany is shrouded in darkness. Nazi zombies walk the earth. You are one of the few remaining living souls in Germany. You have arrived at an abandoned village en route to Berlin, hoping to find a working vehicle.
Sorry, I was just listening to this. Like, I love the narrative and, like, the narration of this. It's awesome. Like, I love it. Like, I love how this game is. Like, I wish more people had it, because it's such a good game. And this came out, like, relatively new, like, when the Xbox was still, like, doing its thing. And also, to give you a heads up, I haven't played a fucking Nazi Army or fucking Sniper Elite game in a while. So, I'm going to give you that for free. Oh yeah, I forgot you can search corpses too. That was another cool feature. So it's like, say you're hard up on ammo or other things, you can just do that. And another thing that I'll say, what's kind of like easier about this when you're playing it on this difficulty compared to, like playing it online with friends and playing it on like a hard difficulty. Like there's not that many zombies, like you can just kind of put it on this difficulty just to have fun. Throwing myself through a fucking tizzy. Oh, there we go, beauty. Bullshot. This is what makes it, man. I love these kill cams. I've always loved it since Sniper Elite 2. Even though I didn't really get that good into the Sniper Elite, I don't explain it. I want to try to get a clap again. Also too, I'm using a gun that a lot of people like to use because it's good to have this much ammo in the clip. So like, compared to, let's say, oh yeah, I forgot, this game fucking records clips like crazy, so that's gonna keep coming out. I forgot about that, so. Shit. Yeah, that's the thing with this game. It records clips like crazy, and I forget what I was gonna say before. Like, this is way more tame than what, like, I want, like, what I've seen a lot of other people play on this and have to deal with. Because, I've been a long time watcher of this Resort play this game with his friends that in the original game. The originals, like, when they weren't even out for fucking Xbox or whatever. Like, the original Zombie Army trilogies. Shit, I'm missing that fucking... Yeah, I've been watching him play that for a long, long, long time. And I was always so interested in this game because I loved, like, just Zombie Army trilogy. And I was kind of, like, annoyed with the developers, because I was like, man, what a, like, really good idea. Oh, I was doing that, I think. Oh, that's bad. so I can poop. But yeah, also you can go down relatively, like, quickly on the fish. Yeah, you can go down relatively quickly on here. It's a very, like, quick thing. But it's not hard to get down on this compared to... Oh, Jesus. Stop, please. Oh, I can't move them back outside of the close place. Oh yeah, I also forgot I can kick their heads off. Oh, I'm dead. Alright, let's just restart from checkpoint. Alright, so... Since I'm not really a fan of just skipping... Okay, so not going out there is good. God, I got a really good caliber to see if I get the chance. Oh, fuck, we'll just go up here. It's perfect. Also, I forgot I can make DMR it also. So, like, say if you don't really like having the, and I'm low on ammo for that gun. To me, when I play this game, I think about two things. How much ammo can my gun hold for me compared to how much damage it can do? But to me, the shotgun can be a beautiful exception. For me, I'm a shotgun guy. When you talk to my friends, it's like, man, most of the time when I'm doing something on the game, it's usually, hey, what's the best shotgun? Yep, perfect. Now we made it in here. You know, I might actually turn this up a little bit. It's actually really dark, and I can't see it on the TV. Oh yeah, that was also another feature, too. I could have it as, like, newsreel, so it's, like, just to show you guys. Because I actually think I can't turn up the gamma. Here. I think the closest thing to that is the newsreel effect. And look at that, it makes it like almost even darker. in some areas, but it looks awesome. Like, I love this type of feature, too. In a game like this. Because just wait, we'll like, actually, like, head out and leave. Like, look at that, it's just beautiful. Looks like one of those, like, old-timey, like, World War whatever movies. Like, World War II movies. Also, I always like the music, too. The music was really cool. That's why, honestly, like, when I saw this come out, like, years and years ago for PC, and it was back in the day, and so it was, like, but it was, like, a, like, hey, like, this is just for, like, school-type shit PC. Like, it doesn't look an all-in-one, or, like, a gaming computer like I have now that I use kind of, like, an all-in-one. But yeah, it's actually fucking, like, it looks crazy. Like, back in this game, it looks so stunning to me. Also, too, I forgot you can do it. You can have a combo meter because of cancer score. Yeah, I really love this effect. Like, I wish more games would do this effect. Also, I'm just gonna see if we're all still here. Yeah, we're all here. My PC hasn't worked in years, so... Also, they jump fucking crazy, like, so... No, I'm dead. Oh man, I keep thinking that I'm playing Resident Evil Revelations, sorry. Like, the, like, on Revelations, the B button is to, like, you know, jump backwards and not have to, like, worry about shit. Okay, we'll do this again. Also, too, if you crouch, you can, like, get better, like, you can be more steady. Plus, also, too, you have a heart rate on the side, so... Also, sorry if people don't like the news reel effect. If you don't, it's, like, sorry. The rest of this video is probably gonna be like this. Oh, come on, give me a triple. Oh, that'd be nice if I got a triple. No, I didn't get a triple. This is probably my favorite game for this. And also, sorry, the whole news reel thing. It's just, I don't know, I really, really like this. Like, I honestly wish more games were, like, black and white. Or, like, didn't have a setting like that, because I don't know, like, it's aesthetically pleasing. And also, too, like, the time period. Like, it's just, I don't know, like, it's just, like, I remember watching these old movies with my grandfather that were, like, you know, military shit, and they were all, like, grainy and black and white, and it's really, like, it's really awesome. And I just wish more games would, you know, have that feature in it. And it's, honestly, it's not even a crazy feature, it's just, like, colorblind. Pretty good combo going here. And see, this is what I mean about, like, the shotgun. Well, I don't know what to do about it. Whoopsie daisy. Figured out how to run again. It's holding down on the thing. Yeah, sorry, I look super rusty as shit right now, because I am. I haven't touched this game in about like a year or two. I forget when this game actually came out. Stop. I keep thinking Resident Evil buttons. Like, I'm pressing B to like try to do that. Like, just try to dodge. Also, too, that's another thing. You can get like heart shots. Chest shots, or yeah, heart shots, because some enemies are actually, like, if you try shooting them in the head, they actually won't die, like, firsthand because of it. Like, that's actually just, you know, a thing for this game. And I thought that was cool, too. Like, they have so many different enemy types. Like, there's so much shit. I love it. And there's a Type 99, there's like that Asian gun. I know Evil Within was a game that tried doing this, and it didn't do bad. But some moments, like the only time Evil Within really did this good was, what do you call it? Yeah, the only time that Evil Within did this really good was when it was to part with your character, like, going up to the mirror. And how, like, the grainy quality would happen. I'm not saying it's, like, a bad thing, it's, like, you know, that's the one thing I can give Evil Within, like, something good. Because Evil Within, to me, I feel wasn't really a bad game, because, you know, since we're on the topic of horror, also do the fogs rolling in, so everybody's gonna be rolling in. Yeah, I forgot, they also have suicide bombers, too. This actually makes you way more ominous, because, like, yeah, I actually can't see them. Like, even with, like, the, with the film grain on. Yeah, this is bad. Like, it's really cool. So that's one thing I actually didn't really like too much about, like, this. In some areas, it just felt too good. And also, too, this gives me kind of like a Dawn of the Dead feeling. Like, that's a good thing that I like. Because, like, one of my favorite zombie games, like, this really gives me that feeling. But except, like, World War II based. Oh, did I get a clap? Oh, I missed them. Shit, I missed them. You fellas are starting to get a little too rambunctious. Okay. How silly. I straight up dodged that dude with that. Oh my god, my fucking leg blew off, too. Alright, now we'll do this again. We're gonna try to, like, finish a chapter or two, at least. But yeah, here, we're gonna turn that off, just cause, Yeah, like, the news really ain't bad. It's just I kind of want to see where these dudes are coming from. Okay. Interact with stuff. See, like, this is what I mean. Like, compared to, like, the newsreel thing, like, you honestly can't see. Like, with this, like, I have more of a, like, vision to see it. But, yeah, I think I went over the whole, like, it's not good to have, like, guns that are 2-2-2, like, powerful. Oh yeah, shit, I forgot I can, like, throw out traps. Also, too bad was another thing, like, film reel kinda doesn't have going. Can't see, like, how, like, I think just the bones are and stuff. Come on, tell me I got a clap. No, I didn't get a clap. PSH. No, I'm on my carbine. Ah, this is bad. There you go, we just Kobe that in there. Oh, I killed myself. I fucking killed myself is the thing. But, yeah, the another thing I forgot to say, these are holdout points. Each mission has, like, a bunch of them. So, to me, I need to do better with that. Shit goes too south, we'll put a landmine right here. Then we'll put some good old dynamite, like, maybe right here if they start coming over here. Then I got my grenades. So I think I'm pretty much set. I do want to pick up that PPSH though. Even though this gun spits like a son of a bitch, it's honestly worth having. Also, too, I should get my gun chill a little bit. It's always nice to be able to fire a bit more steadily. Like, later parts in the game, like, legit, it plays a lot like zombies, or Nazi zombies, where, you're always constantly running. Because I know Adolf Hitler, the main bad guy in this game, I got a couple people, that's good. He has like a zombie factory. Like the combos and things are plus like more like messed up things. Hey dog, that's totally fine. Come on in. That's my daddy picked up the big one. Yeah. He has more people doing it, but still, it's like, you know, man, it's crazy seeing him do some of the shit on here with his friends, because I know they usually live stream it, you know, maybe just to get some, like, some different gun action in here. Let's use the good old Car 98. Like, to me, my favorite is the one that I just had in my hands. But maybe a new gun will help that. But yeah, why at the start of the video also I said, like, not a lot of people really liked this game was because, it didn't receive well with, like, new people, like, trying this. A lot of people actually just weren't really into this. Even though it's me, I enjoy all of these games. Like, I just think Mafia Zombies as a whole, or like... Yeah, Mafia Zombies as a whole is just a really, really good thing. And I like that Call of Duty's been keeping it living for, like, forever now. But it's nice to see games, like, you know, put on a spin. Oh, it's like right near that dude's head. Okay, I'm starting to hear a blade of wood. They take two. people like that. Where, like, legit, it's like, you know, they, like, it doesn't take super limited. It's just, like, one, then it's automatically loaded. But still, it's like, I don't know. It's just, it's a pet peeve. Also, too, it's just, like, holding them on the clip. It just feels a lot better on this game. You know, to me, on other games, I would totally fucking argue that. I died by nothing. Like they're not like the best, but still they're the people I've seen do it the best, pretty much. So to me, the M1 carbine, good gun. Like the other bolt actions, not so much. They're good to do damage, but, you know, I don't know. I should make a fallback point. I can just throw this. Cancel. Alright. I didn't mean to pick up the Weebly, but that's alright. The Weebly's not half bad either. The Weebly is a revolver. The pack's a fucking punch. But, you know, like any powerful weapons, you don't have that much ammo with it. Like, that's why, to me, like, my babies on here are either the shotgun, the carbine, and then the Luger. Because the Luger's good. I like the Luger, it's just I'm super rusty. Also, too, I forgot I have more dynamite, so I'm gonna drop you right there. I thought I got three. Oh man, it's love to see myself get another collab. And so I dipped the top of his head. Oh, that should have hit that other guy. Oh, come on. Come on, fellas. Come on. Okay, so no, I just keep getting ones. I didn't even wish I was around. Oh, it's turning into Halloween. Sweating Nazis done. Are we all done now? You can see them by the yellow of their eyes and kill them. And any love this video. This is another favorite gun of mine, and it's just, it's disappointing. Like, to me, like, I fucking love the Mawson gun. It's, like, my favorite rifle, like, probably in the world. Ever since, like, like, all the Call of Duty games, like, like, I don't know, like, the Mawson has just, oh shit, like, put a place in the game where it's like, man, this is a good game, and it's awesome. Like, even Metal Gear Solid 4, like, they had the special, like, Mawson gun that, like, fires fucking, what do you call it, like, tornadoes. And I'm missing the shot. Like, the Mawson gun's the best. But for me in this game, like, it's not bad because you can fire pretty good. But like I said, like, to me, I just honestly prefer certain enemy foods. Shot on them, and if you kill them, they will come back. Even if it says, hey, they're killed, like, somebody can res them and bring them back. That was good enough. Also, too, there's a, like, gold bar in there somewhere. Two. Oh, I wish I could. Oh. Oh, it didn't count going through the one guy. Come on, man. I can't believe I didn't count going through the one dude. That's fucking upsetting. That's actually super upsetting. I love seeing their hats fly off. Like, man, I could play this game for hours. Like, that's what I love about the Nazi, like, zombie trilogy games. Like, I could play this for hours. I don't know, it's just, it's so satisfying, like, blowing a fucking Nazi's head off. Like, I don't know. It's just, it's so satisfying. And like, for them being zombies, too. Oh yeah, that's another thing I forgot about. I love the safe house symbol. The safe house symbol is amazing. It's just like, hey, little house with a happy face on it. Oh, I love it. Fucking love it. Got the Luger. Lee Enfield. Safe room door. Shotgun. What other guns we got here? Type 99. The Turkov is a pistol. The Weebly. M1 carbine. Ah, fuck. We'll give this fucking, like, Chinese rifle some love, too. Alright, let's go. Because, yeah, I love every sniper in this game. It's just... We're already into it. I forgot that this is another holdout point. Stand your ground. I'm missing. That's super hard. I love it. And here's where they start bringing out spooky, scary skeletons. Do the good old fashioned way. That was also another thing too. With this version of the game, they made the skeletons a little bit more tame because you can kick them down, and that was a good thing. Like, honestly, the skeletons were kind of fucking annoying from what I saw from what do you call it? From Mr. Sark and all of his friends playing together. Your bone like is just blocking my bullets. Yeah, the zombies are a cool feature. Also, I know later in this level, because like I've been up to like half this game, and I just like quit playing. Because like, you know, when you don't have any friends to play with, like, it's just the time of day. But yeah, no, like, that's just kind of, it's the bad thing about this game. Like, it's a good thing and a bad thing. Like, it was a game where, honestly, you can... let me see. MP44, why not? I don't know, I'll give it, like, a round or two. Because I would actually like to get to the elites and the other people. But, now I'm actually gonna try. Yeah, like, it was kind of a bad thing about this game and a good thing. Like, it was good that, like, everything's still, like, doable, but... My brain's just like, man, you got Resident Evil on the brain. Got Revelations on the brain to dodge stuff. Put some might be like, man, that was such a waste of a grenade. It's like, man, it's been forever since I've played this. I feel rusty as shit. Funny thing was, I used to be able to complete this level with, like, little to nothing having my M1 carbine. That is my baby. No other gun on this side. Like, to me, like, yeah, it's kind of, like, I don't find it to be overly good. But it's a really good gun. It's strong. I'm not gonna say it's just, like, any other gun to shoot. Because I'm afraid, like, ammo is just the only priority for me in this game. That's why I have to get ammo. I did, like, literally fucking nothing. That's another strategy I forget too. Like, a lot of these new zombie games, like, they have a little bit of a whatever. Like, they honestly know that it's super easy to do shit. Like, with this, it's like, against your face guns and stuff. Part of the problem is it's like 2 to 10. That looks like right there, I just blew through that. That was honestly the block. Or not the block, it was just kind of like, you know, I took my time and just did chill and just get it done. So yeah, now we should be fighting the elites. And elites are fucking annoying. Like, straight up. They are, like, one of the most annoying enemies in the game.
say that was like two hits, maybe two to three. Like, I got lucky that dude just kept fucking swinging. Like, there are designated locations, but it's not like, hey, run over here to do it. And I don't include the safe rooms to do that, because to me, how I feel the safe rooms are, it's like for Left 4 Dead, for example. Like Left 4 Dead, they have safe rooms. You know, they might not have everything that's in there right at the time. But still, it's like that's where you restock and you heal, you do the whole thing. So this is how it's going to be. Except like finishing the challenge. With this game, it's more of, hey, you know, we're just gonna, we're gonna send you on your way after this. Like, I honestly kind of like how this game did the whole, like, you know, thing. Like, to me, I like how they did it more. One out. Oh, it's horrible. Still thinking a leak's gonna be coming. So please, just anybody give me ammo. I'm like, shotgun? Ah, I've killed the leak with a shotgun before. I'm happy with it. 44. Oh, is there another one here? Surprising. Oh wait, no, I was playing it on a harder difficulty, I think, and the loot comes there. Okay. No, sorry, I'm getting ahead of myself. Ah, there we go. Perfect. Also, too, I'm gonna get rid of this fucking Weebly. This Weebly's a shit. Also, too, the Panzerstrike. Whatever you would want to call it. It's a good gun. Like, honestly, when you're in a pinch, and let's say you just find it randomly lying around, there's my baby. Give me the Luke. There we go. Perfect. Got my whole thing back to normal. It's definitely worth having. Oh yeah, I forgot. Fuck snipers. Yeah, I totally forgot that was a thing. Dude out of the air, like right before he was about to jump out of the air. I remember seeing him do that on Zombie Army Trilogy 2, I think. There we go, I got him. Perfect. after that really depressing gun battle. There we go, fuck you. See, look at there, even using a gun that has a clip on it. Cause like, it's just, it's so much better, like, I don't know. Oh wait, I forgot there's two. Oh, I forgot about this part. Oh man, it's been like a year since I fucking played this. Okay. So yes, I have everything. But that dude's just laughing. So he's upstairs. See how long has this been going? Okay, no, we're still good. I was so trained back, like, back when I played this a shit ton, where honestly I didn't even need to fucking have it out this far. That's really garbage that I'm like just this garbage now at this game. I'm gonna fuck these guys too, like legit, fuck them. We don't fucking do that anymore. Actually about to die. Keep your hat down. Alright, so now we chill a little bit. While they're running or some shit like that. Some fucking retarded. Oh my god, I hate when you guys just stand up there. I hate it so much. Oh my god, I can't believe I'm just not fucking hitting this guy. Like, this is terrible. There. Jesus. I feel that I can say that I care about this game, like, to get off of, like, me being super shit at this right now. My favorite kill that we can do is, what was it? Like, either shooting the dynamite out of somebody's hand or shooting their arms or like shooting the sniper guys through the glass of the sniper. I thought that was always the coolest way to kill somebody. Because if you see that in movies, like where it's like they're looking through a sniper scope and then they see another dude like with a sniper and then they headshot the dude like through his scope. Like arms and screams and the badass looking at it. Soon. That's the only gun that I can be like. If you ever find this gun, pick it up. It's worth it. Also, this is the last part of the level. I didn't know how long this was going to take me. To be honest with you, how I thought this video was going to be was like a couple minutes. It lasted almost like an hour, I think. So, like, what that's telling me is I need to quit playing this and record another thing. Because I'm fucking past due recording shit. So, alright, here's my favorite gun. You can call it whatever you want. Elephant gun, you can call it whatever, but to me, this is my baby, the Preacher. The Preacher. This is the most powerful gun in the game. Hands down, it is the most powerful gun. You will not find anything else more powerful than it, because it's a drop weapon. And like any of us, we all know that drop weapons can only be dropped in specific locations. So, that means we can go to creatures in each level. I also picked up the ones. That's an animal, well, tough mode, whatever this is. That's a car 98, I can do that. About some guns on this game, but to me, how I feel about the main reason why people didn't like this game was because, oh wait, we talked about Sniper Elite as a game, but also to, like, compared to, like, Sniper Elite 3, like, this is more, like, downgraded graphics, like, I'm not gonna lie, this is a fun game to play by this, like, and when I mean that, I mean it as, like, compared to Sniper Elite 2, it's like, this is a really three head two-player co-op. It's you and, like, this black guy who's pretty much you, like, the alternate you or whatever, and that was fun, but for this, it's like, it's like Left 4 Dead. Like, think about that. Would you rather be playing Left 4 Dead with a person, like, with nobody? Because also too, you cannot have bots on this. That was kind of a missed opportunity. And also too, I feel that was intentional, because you know, maybe having bots or whatever would have made it a bit easier. But still, it's just that's what I'm saying. Also too, it was like, headshot, you guys. Are we gonna see an elite? Elite here anytime soon. Because when I see an Elite, we can end it. Yeah, this game is just, it's hard. But then last minute, I honestly just buckled in and started playing with people. And to me, I still like to disappear because, you know, all the people that started to come out for me, I honestly just lost interest. It's like, not even a bad game, just like, and I was like, you gotta think too, like Rebellion, it's like you gotta think about it. It's like, you know, their games are gonna be buggy because they try getting like the most realistic, like the war, you know, all this stuff. And I think most people played it, it was like first release, and honestly, it's like they updated it. They pushed it through this game and it looks good. Like, the main key issue is that nobody fucking plays this game. Like, that's just the issue. Like, I remember I tried, like, talking my buddy into buying this game, and he just didn't want to do it because he was like, man, I'm not a big fan of Sniper Elite, and, you know, I don't think I like it. It was like, you know, and, like, to me, how I felt about it, like, I had to tell him, was like, man, this game is just kind of like, shit gets crazy. Like, this is really tame for what's happening right now. I'm not very good. I found it. Those guys can tear their assholes up super hard. They are nothing to do with it. Just like beat it and then, you know, go. Okay, good. So, perfect. go, I gotta go, I gotta go. Okay, we're gonna hold on. Take a deep breath. Also, too, those dudes melee you, they can fuck you up in, I think, like, one shot. Oh my god. Oh, it's been forever. Fuck. Like, I should have wrecked that dude, like, one shot. Also, I might put on this rule, because I honestly can't fucking see anything. I really need to recalibrate my TV for the spooky. Yeah, all in all, this game was good. I love this game for what it is. Like, it's a really good one. It's just, man, I just wish I had more people to play with. And I always hate to be just like that. One more time. Fucking stick time in my little set there, it's really fucking me up here. I didn't do a really good job setting up all the traps here. I just honestly couldn't do that. Because I don't think I knew the best strats. Scared me because I heard the fucking thing just start doing its noise. Ah! to be like, hey, you know, I've done one. Like, I didn't quit halfway through. Because I just kept getting my fucking, like, peckers stomped in by these fucking zombies. The fucked up thing is, like, yeah, the funny thing about it is, like, this is the hardest one. Because this was too easy. And it's been like a year since I played it, and I'm just rusty, and that's just can't do it. Also, shit needs to go. Cause he's actually blending in now. Come on, fellas, let's go. No, I'm done. You know, I'm gonna end it right here because I'm tired of making a goddamn fool of myself. And I don't want this to turn into a Let's Play because I know for me I would constantly shit the bed. And the worst part about this is, like, honestly, I don't know what to say. I really don't. Like, I love this game when it first came out. It was super good. It was just, it was what I wanted. And now that everything's just kind of dead, it's, I don't know, it's just kind of there. So, I don't know. Like, and also too, if anybody, like, let's say in the comment section or whatever, if they have this game and they want to get in contact with me, like, you know, just type in the section, and I'd totally play this with you guys. Because, yeah, it's just, I don't know, it's hard to play this game on your own. Like, I don't know. And to me, it's like, me constantly failing over and over and over and over and over again. It's just like, you know, you don't really want to have to do that. So, I don't know. I hope you guys enjoyed.